The Budget Committee, chaired by the Kachumbala County MP Patrick Iziagio-Palot, convened to receive the budget framework paper for the financial year 2023-2024 from the Minister of Finance, but to their dismay, the minister snubbed the meeting without a convincing excuse.
In a year, as a budget committee like this, and remain with all the faith that it is going to be good with our colleagues. Chair, I want to believe and agree with colleagues on the commitments and the submissions they've made. But there's one more thing. I still doubt, and my telepathy tells me that even on Monday they will not be there.
Note, and everybody must note that it's only Parliament which takes a lot of trouble to do scrutiny of the whole process. It's only Parliament through our sector committees who do deep interactions with the different sectors, and that's where justifications of these budgets are coming from.
In December, the Minister of Finance, Matia Kasaija, tabled before Parliament the National Budget Framework paper, totaling up to 49.9 trillion shillings for the financial year 2023-2024, and he was expected to present it to the Budget Committee in detail, but he was a no-show. Iziagi noted with concern that such delays will make it difficult for Parliament to pass the budget in the stipulated timelines as provided by the Public Finance Management Act.
Expected Finance today to give us the highlight, and based on the law and the time limits given for this, we needed to start seriously, and that's why we arranged for this interaction with Finance to give us the full highlight.
The fifth, so by we have 15 days to close that business. So chairperson, who are here for sector committees, you have 15 days.
Parliament has up to 1st February to scrutinize and adopt the budget framework paper. But sectoral committee chairpersons expressed fear that they may not get time to meet all ministries, departments and agencies if the Minister of Finance continues to play hide and seek.
Time frame, and they always bring their things very late so that they disorganize Parliament. At the end of the day, they blame Parliament for failure to perform on time. We cut short our holiday with our voters. The technical people are outside the country enjoying their holiday. They should have factored it in their program.
Being able informed by your leadership that we are left with only 15 days. But even that is going to be affected because we still have to convene on Monday to harmonize our positions here as chairpersons, meaning that we will be losing 3 days. Possibly we'll be left with 11 days. But then the question is, how are we going to have a very good output within the remaining days?
However, Parliament is faced with a dilemma on how to proceed with the 2023-2024 budget, which was drafted in a program-based budgeting format, while parliamentary committees to scrutinize the budget are designed in the sectoral form.
We are in sectors, and our rules provide for sectors. Now the BFP has come in programs, and we thought we should not do our own guesswork. We thought we first get a full explanation from Finance, and then we have the highlight. Then we make a strategy on how we are to proceed.
Iziagi noted with concern that based on the rules, the budget issues are handled by the sector committees, which are linked to votes. But when the budget framework paper is in program format, there is need to get them details and links to see how the committee can proceed.
Diction with our rules of procedure. Now, I recognize that government has been engaged in mergers and mainstreaming of ministries, departments and agencies. But we are not seeing the linkage between those mergers at the ministerial level and now the BFP, and this poses a problem.
By law, the budget is handled by sector committees of Parliament, which are linked to votes. But the budget framework paper is program-based, which has sparked confusion in the House. The Finance Ministry has been given up to Monday next week to present the budget framework paper. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.